NSFW, what is the thing you envy of the opposite sex? Not carrying the risk of accidentally crushing your balls. Thanks for making me instinctively tense up. Being able to whip it out and pee anywhere easily and not having to use toilet paper to dry off. Okay, but random boners right before having to give a presentation is some. I guess there is that. Still trying to figure out our equivalent to that. Menstruation is all I can think of and it makes perfect sense, but I feel a random boner is worse than accidental bloodstains or starting in public at school. For some reason, periods are viewed as more natural. What I mean is, it's poor girl and understanding versus ew and disgust or discomfort. As a man, being able to be friendly with kids that aren't my own and nurturing in general without being worried about how it's perceived by others, well, some at least, as being sinister or weird. Don't like to say good things about myself, raised to be modest and all. But I'm really good with kids. Able to engage with them at a level they understand and teach them while being friendly. Probably comes from having a sis 6 years younger. Be patient, entertain and protect. I understand why people are suspicious these days, but if I was a woman, I don't think I'd have to worry about it so much. That would be nice. Having periods though, I have some friends who are often absolutely wrecked by those. Lol, how soon till someone posts asking what is the thing you don't envy about the opposite do you think? Knew a guy who moved from Ethiopia to Sweden. He'd go straight to kids at playgrounds and kids in strollers to say hi and play with them or talk to the parents. He told me in Ethiopia, if there's kids around you, keep an eye on them and interact no matter whose kid it is. Learn pretty quick the Swedes think you're a serial killer or a pedophile. Which is funny, because his instinct is to look out for the kids. If everyone acted the way he did, it would probably be much harder for a predator to actually be able to act. The trade-off might be it would be slightly easier for them to get closer to a child. No periods. Edit, my very first rip my inbox. Glad three words could rally both sides and give some tips to all. I see your no periods and raise you, no uterus be gone, vile organ. I wish it were possible to donate the uterus to someone who wants kids but physically can't have them, due to no uterus or a misshapen or messed up one. Like, oh sis, you want kids. Here ya go, take this child bag and egg dispensers. Being able to pee your name in the snow. How much water do you drink? A lot. Still will never be able to accomplish this? Clothing options. I feel like women have such a broad range of clothing options compared to men. And you can wear leggings without being seen as weird at it. I'm buying some leggings. Skirts. Every time I have to peel my sack off my thigh or pull off some weird little dance to get it to release so I can sit down without pinching a nut, I wish kilts or some sort of skirt-type apparel were the norm for men in the summer. FYI, a kilt is made up of about 6 yards of heavy wool. Have fun with that. Spent many summers going from one Highland game to the next with my bagpiper mother. Female, here. Things I envy about men: decent pockets in clothing, never expected to wear heels, can pee standing up, much less shaving needed to be socially acceptable in summer, can usually reach higher shelves without a step ladder. Things I don't envy: out of context boners, expectation to never be emotionally vulnerable while the face has a lot less surface area than everything I'm expected to shave. It seems like a much more complicated job, much less choice for work clothes, general societal views on masculinity and lack of freedom to act outside of that without judgment. Edit, I see now that I was horribly misguided about how easy it is for men to pee standing up without making a mess. Thank you for educating me, men of Reddit and GT. While the face has a lot less surface area than everything I'm expected to shave, it seems like a much more complicated job if shaving your face is an art form than shaving your balls is brain surgery. I hate making the first move. Would be nice not to have to. There goes my notifications. Thank you all for your nice comments. This. I believe what I say next has to go for both genders, but when people call others dens, I really feel for them because it's so hard to tell with people. One person's being friendly is another person's flirty is another person's OMG have me RN. The emotional support. I may have A, but I do have heart as well, however unbelievable and surprising it may sound. I always appreciate someone showing they actually do care about me. I always treasure it. I find it unbelievable people actually think dudes don't have feelings and don't like compliments. I've heard that you guys don't get complimented often, and when you do, you treasure it, and I feel like it should be a normal thing just like most girls. I can remember multiple specific instances of someone who wasn't a family member or so, complimenting me, and they all stand out as treasured memories. Of course, it's nice that I have those warm memories, but it would be nice if I had more material to work with than 5 years ago that a high school classmate said my shirt was nice. Easier ability to age and it not be considered something to hide or cover up, but something that can even be seen as more distinguished or respectable. OMG, yes, I feel like there's a connection to why many women are insecure about getting old. Like getting crow's feet, wrinkles, more prominent smile lines are so particularly pointed out in women, not so much in men. So many beauty products advertised as anti-aging, anti-wrinkles. The worst part is when they compare ordinary women to Hollywood celebrities, you know, the millionaires. Not being ridiculed for being emotional and vulnerable. Bro, I'm here for a hug anytime you want. Not having periods. Not having to deal with the side effects of birth control. Telling men you like K-pop is 100% effective with no side effects. Ha ha ha, unfortunately I also take it for period-related reasons too. I want to stand and pee jerk off easier, and it looks fun. You forgot you can wiggle it like a propeller. The helicopter. Cringe edit, how TF did a joke about get 400 upvotes. I remember leaving a friend's house with my year-old baby girl and she was not having it. As I carried her to my car she was crying up a storm. I have never felt more judged or nervous about carrying my own child as I did on that 32nd walk to my car. My wife and other moms just didn't understand why I felt nervous. Try the same with a baby that doesn't match your skin color. My wife is black and I am white, so our kids are a blend between. Try walking out a door at Walmart with a screaming kids that doesn't match you and security is on. You like stink on. Wow, are you serious? This honestly makes me a little sad, man. Just keep being a good dad, bro. I grew up without one, so your kiddos are lucky. How easy reproduction is for men. Yes, I understand they have their own issues, but I would swap any day. The constant unease when you know you are close to your period. Is it discharge or did I bleed? If I stand up, will I leave a mark? The monthly general uncomfortableness, pain, moods, bloating and cost of periods. The side effects of birth control and cost of it. The fear of unwanted pregnancies. The stigma of abortions. And the fact men don't have to up their bodies to bring kids into the world. Very, very envious of this. I've used menstrual cups for about 2 years and it's liberating. A bit messy but liberating. I have one that holds 25 milliliters of blood. You just put it up there and you're good for up to 12 hours. I don't need pads, tampons, panty liners. I can swim without issue, sleep without waking up with a gush, and exercise without getting gross. Way lower chance of leaking, spotting. Highly recommend. Guy here. My wife swears by menstrual cups. She has some that fold up into a tiny case you can take pretty much anywhere, so you'll never have to worry about not having it. She also has period panties as a backup method sometimes. Unfortunately, these are still poorly understood, so be ready for some weird interactions with doctors. Nothing medically worrisome, just a lot of "what is that?" from doctors that aren't as up to speed on alternatives as they probably should be. Not having your body torn up by pregnancy and giving birth. Right under this comment is a dude who's envious of woman's ability to give birth. Haha, humanity, am I right? Losing your ability to hold your pee after two births kinda negates the wonder of giving birth. Love my kids but don't like the depends pads. Not getting a boner at the funeral service. I mean, my grandfather is hot but come on. My grandfather never looked hotter than when he was being cremated. Being less susceptible to contracting UTIs. S. Painful. Hash wipe front to back hash use a new condom hash pee right after hash and a me and right after hash soap to zinti kill vibrators hash use a clean finger hash if you work out don't wait till morning to shower and they didn't tell me that in education. I'm so lucky I learned all that in Yahoo Answers, Reddit, and my doctor's office before getting bottom surgery because that would have gone very badly. I'm jealous of how men can pee in the woods on hiking trips. Multiple. Straight up. Not all women are capable of multiple. I'm not sure how common that is though. I ain't even capable of one WTF. I just want to be listened to. You have no idea how impossible it is to be a woman in a small town where everyone still holds the same 1950s values. Nobody ever takes me seriously, nobody listens to what I have to say, and nobody thinks I have good ideas until a man repeats them. And I can't even get angry about it because then I get "you're cute" when you're mad, or is it that time of the month? Also, being able to exist on the internet without getting pictures of people's genitals sent to me all the time would be nice. Get out of that crappy town. I have an overactive bladder. I do anything to be able to neatly pee in a bottle. Edit, I'm saying this is someone with a medical condition who's had to pee in a cup or bush many times when I couldn't get to a restroom quick enough. I've even peed my pants before. There, I said it. Please relax. IDK, duct tape a funnel. Not being seen is always chasing. I hate that I can't sit down and get to know someone without them thinking that I want to get in their pants. Also, people cross the street so they don't walk next to me at night. I totally understand why this happens, and why it should happen, and I support people protecting themselves. I just wish we didn't live in a society where this was necessary. Don't forget the classic walking uncomfortably fast to overtake the girl in front of you so that she doesn't think you're stalking her. Divorced dads have entered the chat. More acceptable to be a stay-at-home parent. I know a dude who owns TF out of being a SAH dad. His wife is a workaholic, loves the stress of work. He'd rather watch the kids and live at their current income level than send them to daycare. When they're old enough for school, he's got plans for work. If someone from my beats someone of opposite people, I'ma report the police. If someone from the opposite beats someone from my people, he must have done something wrong. Totally worth a beating. I imagine this was commented by a male, and I hate this mindset so much. People need to see that both crimes are equally bad. I saw a post in our Insane People Facebook and there was a news report of a woman raping and then killing her husband, and people were in the comments like, well, he probably deserved it, besides women get raped all the time so who cares, and that is so terrible. Who thinks that's okay?